Today, we talk about the projectile motion under the unit motion in a plane. In this video, we will prove that the path of the projectile is a parabola. To prove the path of the projectile is a parabola, first of all, we must know what is a projectile. The projectile is a particle or an object which is thrown with some initial velocity with certain angle with horizontal direction near the surface of the earth. Why do we say that near the surface of the earth? The projectile will undergo the influence of only gravitational force. Here, let us represent the horizontal and vertical motion of the projectile along the x-axis and y-axis simultaneously. Let's consider a particle is thrown with initial velocity u with an angle of theta with the horizontal direction. Now, to know the motion along the horizontal direction and along the vertical direction, you must resolve the component of velocity into two. This u can be resolved into u sine theta along vertical direction and u cos theta along the horizontal direction. Now, to write the equation for the distance covered in horizontal direction, you can simply write the velocity into time. Why? Because there is no force acting on it here. Therefore, only the product of velocity and time will give us the displacement. So, let's write that equation first. So, this is u cos theta times t. Now, for the vertical motion, it's not the case, because in the vertical motion, the gravitational force is acting on it. That means the particle's vertical component of velocity is under the influence of gravitational force. So, you cannot simply write the displacement or the height which is covered by the projectile along the vertical direction by using the speed and time product. So here you have to make use of the equation which we have learnt in motion in one dimension with uniform acceleration. So we can write the equation y is equal to mg sin theta minus half g t square. This is looking like s is equal to ut plus half g t square. And here the force is reducing the velocity of the vertical component. Therefore, we have written minus half g t square. These are the two equations governing the entire motion of projectile. Now let's take the value of t from the first equation and then substitute in the second one. The value of t from the first equation is x by u cos theta. Now let's substitute in the second equation. Here the second equation shows that u sin theta into t. In place of t, I have substituted x by u cos theta and minus half g t square. Again, x by u cos theta whole square. I can cancel out this u and this u, and then sin theta by cos theta is resulting as tan theta, and this x will come here, and this is half g. When you squared it, x square divided by u square cos square theta. So it can be represented as y is equal to ax plus bx square, where a is equal to tan theta and b is equal to half minus half g u square by cos square theta. A is equal to tan theta and b is equal to minus half g u square by cos square theta. So this equation is really very important in solving some of the numericals, because it gives a relation between the horizontal range covered and then vertical height. When you know the value of initial velocity and then you know the angle of projection, then we can find a relation between the vertical height covered and the corresponding horizontal range covered at that particular point of time. Now, in the projectile motion, let us observe the beautiful animation from physics animations site. Here, this banana is undergoing the influence of gravitational force of attraction. So, if you look at the path of this banana, it is a projectile. In this video, you can see me throwing the basketball in a parabolic path. In this video, I have used the open software called Tracker, which gives even the path of the ball. You can see the red dots. This is the basketball court of KV Museum Center, Bangalore, and the person who is shooting the basket is none other than me, KSV Someswar Rao.